Hey there, mathematicians, it's Justin again. And Mia. We've met a lot of Mia's family members by now. They've been visiting and helping us with our math facts, and today, Mia's cousin Bevan is gonna help us with our 11's. Ooh, that must be them. Bevan, welcome. Wow, you brought a lot of equipment with you. Let me help you bring it all in. Skis, boots, poles, gloves, skates, sticks. And I'm noticing they're all in pairs. Looks like we have everything we need to enjoy the snowy weather and learn some strategies that can help us confidently multiply and divide by 11. Have your guided notes ready, mathematicians, and let's hit the slopes. We left the front door open a little too long. Ooh, good, some warm-up problems. In your guided notes, solve 2 times 11, 5 times 11, and 8 times 11. 2 times 11 equals 22, 5 times 11 equals 55, and 8 times 11 equals 88. Based on all the math fact work we've done throughout these units, we already know nearly all of our 11s. But now that we're focusing on 11s specifically, what do you notice about these answers? Each answer has a matching pair of digits that are the same as the single digit factor. Kind of like all the matching pairs of equipment Bevan brought. So based on that pattern of answers with matching digits, would that mean 10 times 11 equals 111? Pause here to record your thinking in your guided notes. Since we know 9 times 11 equals 99, one more group of 11 would be 110. We also know from our work with Ren that multiples of 10 will always end in 0. It seems as though our matching digit pattern stops once we start multiplying 11 by two-digit numbers. So, how do we figure out 11 times 11 and 11 times 12? Oh, phew! Bevan says there's another strategy we can use to help. Let's check it out. Here we have 10 times 11 and 1 times 11. And these problems can be used to help us solve 11 times 11. Huh. Why do you think Bevan used the factors 10 and 1? Oh, because 10 plus 1 equals 11. Interesting. So 10 times 11 is 110, and 1 times 11 is 11. Now, what can we do with these products to help us get the answer to 11 times 11? We can add them together. 110 plus 11 equals 121, which means 11 times 11 equals 121. This process of solving two smaller multiplication problems to help figure out the answer to a bigger multiplication problem is known as the partial product strategy. It's a way to solve more complex multiplication problems by breaking down a factor into smaller parts, multiplying each part by the other factor, and then adding those amounts together to find the total. Try using the partial product strategy to solve 12 times 11. Think about how you'll break 12 into smaller parts to solve and record your thinking in your guided notes. In the first example, Bevan used 10 and 1 to make 11. So what numbers could we use to make 12? 10 and 2 make 12, so let's use those. 10 times 11 equals 110, and 2 times 11 equals 22. Now that we have these partial products, what should we do next? We need to add them together. 110 plus 22 equals 132, which means 12 times 11 equals 132. Even if you broke down 12 into different amounts like 9 and 3 or 6 and 6, your total product should still be 132. As long as the smaller parts add up to 12 and each part is multiplied by 11, you'll still get the same answer when you add them together. That's a good point, Bevan. It can take some time to get comfortable with a new strategy like this. We'll have more opportunities to practice in the PDF and in our next lesson. But in the meantime, let's explore how we can use what we've learned so far to help with division. When we multiplied 11 and a one-digit factor, like 11 times 2 or 11 times 5, the product followed a predictable two-digit pattern. But I wonder, is there a similar pattern for division? In your guided notes, solve 33 divided by 11, 44 divided by 11, and 66 divided by 11. (33 divided by 11) = 3, 44 divided by 11 = 4, and 66 divided by 11 = 6. What do you notice about the pattern for dividing by 11? Since multiplication and division are inverse operations, the pattern is the opposite. When dividing a two-digit number with the same digits, like 33, 44, or 66, by 11, the quotient will be a matching one-digit number. And what about problems like 77 divided by 7 or 99 divided by 9? All those matching digits tell us the quotients must be 11. Ooh, that's right, Bevan. For problems with three-digit dividends, like 110 divided by 11 and 132 divided by 11, we can use our fact families to help us solve. Think back to our earlier work with partial products. You can even look back in your guided notes. What's the third related number that's missing from each equation? Pause here and record your thinking. 110 divided by 11 equals 10, and 132 divided by 11 equals 12. Fact families, patterns, skip counting, partial products, we have so many strategies to choose from when solving problems. So, what have we learned today besides the fact that Bevan's brilliant at breaking down 11s and supplying snowy weather sports equipment? Well, now you know that multiplying 11 by a single-digit factor will equal a matching product with two of the same digit. And partial products can be used to help you multiply 11 by any factor. You also know two-digit dividends divided by 11 will equal a matching single-digit quotient. And fact families can be used to help solve any multiplication or division fact problem. Be sure to complete the practice questions and extension activities that go with this lesson to practice multiplying and dividing by 11. Thanks for helping us with our 11s today, Bevan, and for bringing all this equipment to share so that we can enjoy the snow together. We have so many different types. Which do we choose? Oh, you're right. Having different types of equipment to choose from is just like having different strategies to choose from. This way, you can pick the one that works best for you, depending on the problem you're solving. Looks like Mia's ready to go skiing. Let's see. Bevan, may I please borrow your extra skis, boots, and poles so we can all go skiing? Awesome! Thanks! Remember, mathematicians, in math, as in life, practice makes progress. I'll see you next time!